Welcome back everyone, it is Mike from ManaHoarders. In this video, we are bringing you a commander deck tech for an Azorius commander, Kwain, Itinerant Meddler. You can cast Kwain for a white and a blue. He is a 1-3 legendary rabbit wizard. You can tap him and each player may draw a card, then each player who drew a card this way will gain one life. Before we dive into the deck, let's go over a few key points. First up, the final price for this build came in at $89.78. That does include the price of our commander and all of our lands. Now do bear in mind this price will vary greatly depending on the quality of the cards you purchase, the vendor you use, and a variety of other factors. In terms of power level, I would rate this deck at around a 6 out of 10 on the power scale. This color pairing is known mostly for a stacks style build. Now we will be taking some of the pieces from that strategy, but we want to slow our opponents down in more of a control style. We will be using various enchantments and hate bear creatures to slow our opponents down and hinder them rather than lock them out of the game. We have plenty of ways alongside our commander to keep gaining life to keep our total high, and we have ways to keep drawing cards to make sure we have an answer for any of our opponents. In this first section, we will be covering the infinite combos and possible win conditions included in this deck. If you're not a fan of infinite combos or win conditions such as these, feel free to substitute these cards out to go with more of a life gain or capitalize off of the card draw provided from the commander. So our first two pieces, we will need Shabraz the Sky Shark and Drog Skull Reaver. Whenever you draw a card, Shabraz will get a 1-1 counter on it and he'll gain you a life. And then Drog Skull Reaver reads, whenever you gain life, draw a card. I believe this is the only card in Magic that straight up says, whenever you gain life, draw a card. Now once these two are on the battlefield, you just need a way to draw a card to start gaining life and then drawing cards infinitely, meaning you can draw through your entire deck. This can be beneficial with a card such as Jace, Wielder of Mysteries. His text reads, if you would draw a card while your library has no cards in it, you win the game. This is very similar to Laboratory Maniac, which we are also including. Now if we can't find one of these pieces, we also have Psychic Corrosion. Whenever we draw a card, each opponent mills 2, meaning once we draw 50 cards, our opponents would have already lost the game. And if that isn't quite doing it for us, we also have Psychosis Crawler. Whenever we draw a card, each opponent will lose 1 life. So once we get this engine going, we can drain their life totals very quickly. Now we'll go ahead and jump into our artifacts. Arcane Signet can add 1 mana of any color of our commander's color identity. Azorius Signet can tap to add a white and a blue to our mana pool. Soul Ring can add 2 colorless mana. And Thought Vessel gives us no maximum hand size and can tap to add a colorless mana to our mana pool as well. For our creatures, first we have the legendary Kiyomaru First to Stand. His power and toughness are equal to the number of cards in our hand. As long as we have 4 or more cards in hand, it has vigilance, and whenever it deals damage, if we have 7 or more cards in hand, we gain 7 life. Apostle of Purifying Light provides some graveyard hate. Archon of Absolution makes our opponents pay 1 to attack us or planeswalkers we control. Archon of Emeria makes it so players can't cast more than 1 spell each turn, and non-basic lands our opponents control enter tapped. Avon Mind Sensor makes it so our opponent's tutors are limited to the top 4 cards of their library. Body of Knowledge has power and toughness equal to the number of cards in our hand, gives us no maximum hand size, and whenever it's dealt damage, we can draw that many cards. Containment Priest will exile any non-token creature that enters the battlefield and was not cast. Descendant of Kiyomaru, as long as we have more cards in our hand than each opponent, it will get +1/+2, and whenever it deals combat damage, we will gain 3 life. Eidolon of Obstruction, loyal ability is the planeswalkers our opponents control cost 1 more to activate. When Forbidding Spirit enters, it makes it so our opponents have to pay 2 for each creature attacking us or planeswalkers we control until our next turn. Hushbringer, creatures entering the battlefield or dying don't cause abilities to trigger. Hushwing Griff, creatures entering the battlefield don't cause abilities to trigger. Imposing Sovereign, creatures our opponents control enter tapped. Same thing with Kinjali's Sunwing. Nadir Kraken, whenever we draw, we can pay 1. If we do, it gets a 1-1 counter and we create a 1-1 blue tentacle creature token. We can greatly slow down combat with Silent Arbiter. No more than 1 creature can attack each combat, and no more than 1 creature can block each combat. Spell Tithe Enforcer, whenever an opponent casts a spell, that player sacks a permanent unless he or she pays 1. Sunscorch Regent, whenever an opponent casts a spell, it gets a 1-1 counter and we gain a life. Suture Priest, whenever another creature enters under our control, we gain 1. Whenever a creature enters the battlefield under an opponent's control, we can have that player lose 1. And Tocatli Honor Guard, creatures entering the battlefield don't cause abilities to trigger. Moving on to our enchantments, Authority of Consoles makes so creatures our opponents control enter tapped, and whenever a creature enters the battlefield under an opponent's control, we can gain 1. Blind Obedience does much the same, except it affects their artifacts as well, and we can use Extort. Whenever we cast a spell, we can pay 1, each opponent will lose 1, and will gain life equal to the life lost this way. Dawn of Hope, whenever we gain life, we can pay 2 to draw a card. It can also create 1-1 white soldier creature tokens with lifelink. Deafening Silence makes it so each player can't cast more than 1 non-creature spell each turn. A personal favorite of mine, Frozen Aether, artifacts, creatures, and lands your opponents control enter tapped. Light of Promise, the enchanted creature has, whenever you gain life, put that many 1-1 counters on this creature. Seal Away, we can exile target tapped creature until Seal Away leaves the battlefield. Seal of Cleansing. I just like having this on the board to kind of keep our opponents in check. We can sacrifice a destroyed target artifact or enchantment. Teferi's Ageless Insight. If we will draw a card except for the first one we draw each turn, we draw two instead. And Telepathy. For one blue mana, our opponents play with their hands revealed. For our instance, Abolish can destroy target artifact or enchantment. Aetherize will return all attacking creatures to their owner's hand. Angel Song can prevent all combat damage that will be dealt this turn. Azorius Charm. Creatures we control can gain lifelink. We can draw a card or put target attacking or blocking creature on top of its owner's library. Dawn Charm can prevent all combat damage that will be dealt this turn, regenerate target creature, or counter target spell that targets you. Deliberate can scry two and then draw one. Disenchant can destroy target artifact or enchantment. Dispel can counter target instant. Holy Day will prevent all combat damage will be dealt this turn. Mana Leak can counter target spell unless his controller pays 3. Negate can counter target non-creature spell. Spell Pierce can counter target non-creature spell unless his controller pays 2. We do have two more planeswalkers we are including besides Jace. Dovin, Hand of Control. Artifact, instant, and sorcery spells our opponents cast cost 1 more. And Narset, Parter of Veils. Each opponent can't draw more than 1 card each turn. With a sorcery such as Bond of Discipline, we can tap all creatures our opponents control, and creatures we control will gain lifelink until end of turn. Cleansing Nova can destroy all creatures or destroy all artifacts and enchantments. Clear the Mind, target player will shuffle their graveyard into their library and we will draw a card. Divination allows us to draw 2 cards, and Hostilities, we can destroy all creatures and permanents attached to those creatures. Open into Wonder, X target creatures can't be blocked this turn, and until end of turn, whenever those creatures deal combat damage to a player, we will draw a card. Preordain will allow us to scry 2 and then draw 1. I've grown quite fond of Selective Snare to keep tribal builds in check. We can return X target creatures of the creature type of our choice to its owner's hand. Sleep can tap all creatures target player controls, and those creatures don't untap during that player's next untap step. And Whelming Wave can return all creatures to their owner's hands except for Krakens, Leviathans, Octopuses, and Serpents. And last but not least is our mana base. We are keeping things very basic with 17 basic islands and 18 basic planes. And just like that, we have reached the end of another Commander Deck Tech. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit the like button, subscribe, tell your friends about us, and leave a comment down below. One of our viewers suggested this commander, so give us new ideas for who we should build around in the future. We really appreciate the support.